I really don't offer any words of encouragement at this point, simply because the amount of injuries and the just the lack of belief in the team that could try to compete with the team that is clearly much better than them. And I'll give you a prime example. His name is Bill Belichick. He's playing with a rookie quarterback, and he's up in New England. Almost beat Tampa Bay and almost beat the Dallas Cowboys yesterday. Two of the better teams that, you know, could be heading, you know, head on to a collision course for the NFC Championship game. And his team fought tooth and nail all the way to the end. Now, those are moral victories, and nobody gives a crap about those.
Sure.
The key is he's got a rookie quarterback. Then the rookie quarterback's going to make mistakes, and he's going to be limited. But they fight tooth and nail to the end of every game. Yesterday was a game for the Giants, and I think I told you this. I know I told you this about 10 minutes ago. There were times in my career where I would step on the field, and specifically in 1992, my last year with Cincinnati before I went back there, and then 1995 with the New York Jets, where I would step on the field knowing that the team that I was playing with had no chance to beat the team that we were playing against. I'm like, it was over before the game even started.
I mean, somewhere deep down in your competitive spirit, you thought, maybe
if the other team's quarterback gets hurt and three of their defensive guys get hurt, like, you know, what happened to the Giants yesterday.
Yeah.
Then maybe we would win the game. Nobody here thought they were going to win the game. But what you did think is that they would fight tooth and nail to the end of the game. And that second quarter was an unmitigated disaster. I mean, it was a disaster of proportions that almost you couldn't stop it. Like, Joe Judge had no answer for it. The players had no answer for it. And it was like a tidal wave of momentum that basically just engulfed the entire Giant team. And it starts with injuries. That's part of the game, and everybody has those injuries. I don't know what's going on over there at MetLife Stadium, but you got guys every week coming out with some sort of leg injury.
Yeah, I mean, when the 49ers complained about that last year, I sort of laughed it off and thought that they were making excuses, but it is now continued.
I mean, with the Giants, it's unbelievable.
And now they are switching to grass, if you have told me, sometime in the near future.
Yep.
Because of this, that makes me think that, yes, there indeed is a problem there.
There's something going on over there.
And then,
you have ankle injuries.
Yeah.
You have foot injuries. You have hamstring and quad injuries. I mean, you have knee injuries that have happened to other teams and even Giant players. There's something that's going on, and I don't know what it is. And I don't want to hear about, you know, the Giants are being worked too hard on Wednesday.
No.
This is why they're getting hurt on Sunday. That's BS. But I will say that yesterday, especially with the honoring of the Super Bowl team and everybody there and the history and all the success that they had once upon a time, the Giants wake up this morning, and since 2017, they are the worst organization in football. The worst. Number 32. And when you think about that, the Jets are on that list. The Jaguars are probably on that list. The Browns are somewhere on that list. The Lions are somewhere on that list. The Washington football team could be on that list. I mean, you're thinking about some of the worst organizations that we have sat here for years and years and years and made fun of. And right now, you have two of the New York football teams as the four worst teams in terms of win percentage over the last 5 years.
Yeah, I mean, they are the butt of all the jokes. It's no longer the Cleveland Browns. I mean, the Houston Texans, they got blown out yesterday, but they've had their issues. I mean, the Jets and Giants are the butt of the jokes. That's what it is. And I think that the Giants, because they've had success and they had those two Super Bowls in somewhat of recent memory, you know, nobody laughs at them like you'd laugh at the Lions or you'd laugh at the Browns, but it's starting to happen. I mean, everybody's laughing at them now, and the Jets are perennially starting over, and that's what the Giants are probably going to have to do again.
And again,
I mean, they're going to have to start over again.
And well, here's the other problem, and you know, this is the realities of the business, and this is usually what makes owners and react to their team, and that is, when you are celebrating a Super Bowl team and you're bringing back, you know, the key players, the coach and everything else, and 20,000 people are missing.
Oh, yeah. No, and a lot of them, I think, might have been there for the beginning of the game and then left. I mean, I whatever the attendance was, I'm not sure. But, yeah, I mean, it just was like, why even show up at this game? It's a beautiful October day. Not too hot, not too cold. Sun, 1 o'clock start, tailgating. You celebrate a championship 10 years from that second Super Bowl with Eli Manning, the whole thing. And the Giants fans don't, well, not all of them. I mean, they still had a decent amount of people, but you got guys leaving at halftime. I mean, the thing that's just inevitable at this point is as they march towards the end of this season, and of course, their only exciting player gets hurt and leaves the game early in Kadarius Toney, which is another thing that was horrible yesterday as we talk about the turf. But as they march towards the end of this season, and God knows how bad it could get, and they might even have the first overall pick, you're just thinking about how there's going to be another seismic shift, whether it's the general manager, the quarterback, and the coach, or just the general manager and the quarterback, or just the but there's going to be another starting over point in New York football with the Jets and Giants. Not going to happen with the Jets because it's year one with Rob Saleh and Zach Wilson. But to me, unless the Giants figure this thing out and then rattle off six or seven wins, which just seems absolutely impossible, they're starting over again. They're starting over again. And probably the same coach, I would think, unless this thing goes completely off the rails. And coming up about 6:20, you'll hear another one of these ridiculous Joe Judge quotes. And we like him. But when you lose and then you throw some of these things out there, it just sounds ridiculous. But just think about that. Again, they've got to start over. And then for 2 or 3 years, we'll have to give them the benefit of the doubt again. Oh, well, they're starting over. They got a new quarterback. It's just years and years and years of digging yourself out of this. And this year wasn't supposed to be one of those years. This year was supposed to be a build off of last year. We both picked them to win the division. I mean, how stupid does that sound today? Shame on me for thinking that they would be good.
Well, we also thought that they would have all their players on the field. I mean, you know,
well,
still, though, man.
Saquon's nothing. It doesn't matter if he's there or not.
I'm saying Saquon's not there. This week, Sterling Shepard's there. Kadarius Toney gets hurt. Kenny Galladay's not there. I mean, to start the season, Evan Ingram's not there. Now Andrew Thomas is out. I mean, it has been. It has a incredible impact. The moment that Andrew Thomas goes out of that game is like, all right, it's over.
Yeah.
It's over. It's absolutely over.
Well, I mean, even though the Giants scored first, the first play of the game where Daniel Jones almost gets his head ripped off.
I know that.
Kicked it through the uprights.
And he basically is running for his life again, and then he's panicking, and he's throwing the ball to the wrong team, and he's fumbling, and it's panic central. And we are in the middle of what is the quintessential negative New York sports experience for player and coach. One is Daniel Jones, and the other one is, of course, Joe Judge. And they are right smack dab in the tsunami of negativity that is New York sports. They are right in the middle of it. You know that.
Yeah.
Just like, you know, Luis Rojas was in it. Just like Sandy Alderson is in it. Just like maybe Aaron Boone is somewhat in it. At least they actually made it to a wild card game. We saw it with the Rangers last year. We've seen it with the Devils over the years. When you get the Jets, you know, it seemed like to start over every 3 years. When you are in this tsunami of negativity and just absolute criticism coming at you left and right. And I know exactly what that stadium felt like yesterday. I know exactly what those players felt like when they stepped on the field. They had no chance. They had no chance to play. And I told you, I'm competitive. They're competitive too. Believe me, they're extremely competitive. But they know that they had no chance, especially when that avalanche of emotion just took their team over in the second quarter. It was like nonstop. It was like one mistake after the next that led to another touchdown by the Rams.
It was a perfect illustration of how far they have to go to be a competitive team.
Yeah, but do you understand what I'm talking about?
Sure.
The world in which the athlete and the coach and, you know, of course, the general manager.
The blender, as you call it.
Right, it is a blender. And then the owner, in this case, John Mara, and maybe Steve Tisch and Jonathan Tisch, all these guys, are sitting there saying, okay, what in the hell do we have to do to get our fan base back? Because our fan base is completely wiped out right now. They have taken and sucked the life out of their fan base.
Yep. No, a fan base that's a proud fan base, is a loyal fan base, is one that's always there and celebrating great moments. Yeah, no, they've beaten it out of them. They have beaten it out because they're not just mediocre. You know, they're not one of those teams that's going to end up 8-9, 9-8. You know, one of these teams, maybe a wild card team, a little disappointing year, whatever it may be. They're not that. I mean, they've been the worst team in football. And statistically, the worst team in football for years. So, yeah, they've beaten it out of them. But, I mean, they're going to really start over again?
Do you remember in the 70s how bad football was around here?
Well, I wasn't alive.
Well,
you don't remember, but yes.
You know the history of how
I remember
was.
How. Yeah, this is probably worse than that, or is it worse than that?
There was a plane flying over Giant Stadium, fire this guy, and I'm sure that Sean McVay remembers those days.
15 years of lousy football, we've had enough.
Because his grandfather got fired, and he just wanted to just rub it into the Giants. Believe me, I'm sure that had something to do with yesterday's beatdown. But, you know, I just think that now is almost akin to then, when all these kids around here grow up as Cowboy fans, Steeler fans, Dolphin fans.
Absolutely, Raiders.
Raider fans, yep. You know, all those great games, you know. And now you're stuck with both franchises going through, well, the Giants are now have regressed significantly to the point where, like, I can't even accept, even look at my text anymore from my Giant fan.
Oh, no, I don't.
And I'm telling you, I have three guys in my life that live for the New York Giants. I could sit here and say that they're probably Yankee, Ranger, and Knick fans too. Mm-hmm. But the Giants are their team.
Sure.
And I can't even look at the text anymore. It's just, it's such a negative tinge attached to it. And the apathy that is now approaching or has approached and taken hold of the Giants, because I thought there was a little bit of an uptick in excitement when Joe Judge first got here. And then when they won, you know, what did they win? Five out of their last six games last year, you felt like, you know, they still had a chance to make it to the playoffs, and Philadelphia, you know, blows the game the last night of the season and all this other stuff, and they change the quarterbacks, blah, 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 blah. But now, I mean, right now, waking up this Monday morning, I really can't remember this level of apathy and disgust that has been now directed right at the Giants.
And that's the worst word for an NFL owner, apathy.
Thank you for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And don't forget to hit the red bell so you're notified when we have new content.